Yeah, I never played fair. So tell me why now should we care? Queen B told y'all a long time ago that we run the atmosphere. Did we build that? Yeah. Do we own that? Yeah. We even in the studios running playback. Shout out to AM and Sally, the young guard, to all the G's like us. Yeah, we go hard. See, this is how we feel it, be a champion. We might fall down, but we never run.
You wouldn't need it if you knew what we overcome.
Do you know all the things we gotta overcome?
But they ain't stopping nothing. Me and my girls on top, straight stunting. And we abide by a real strict code. Hands off my ex and homies over.
If you try to shut us down, we'll show you just how we get down.
We play, our way.
I'd rather be me.
Do work.
All day. We don't see defeat.
Can we fly that?
Yeah.
Can we buy that?
Yeah.
We even run a full court, make a stack.
Yeah.
Shout out to Maya Moore, the young guard, to all the girls like us. Yeah, we go hard. See, this is how we feel it, be a champion. We might fall down, but we never run.
So proud of the that we overcome.
Do you know
we bow down to none. I wanna hail out all my dear ones. Time really does fly when you're having fun. But the party don't stop till we staring down the sun.
If you try to shut us down, we'll show you just how we get down. And just to even up the score, we're coming kicking down your door. If you try to shut us down, we'll show you just how we get down. And just to even up the score, we're coming kicking down your door.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. Today's matchup features a very good defense. The Cowboys are top 10 in fewest points allowed. They'll be up against a Niners offense that wants to hang a big number on them. Set for the call of this Week 8 matchup, let's bring in our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and Mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Today, we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here between the San Francisco 49ers and the Dallas Cowboys. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. They come out here in the eye. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And on the ground they go with the running back. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
3rd play here, this opening drive, as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Looking to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
3rd down is the down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
Taken in at the 22. That'll wind up being a 50-yard punt, though they do get 10 back on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10.
Here it goes.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. And when this offense is clicking on all cylinders, the running back is in sync as well.
The focal point. Runs, catches, blocks, sets a tone for the offense.
Double tight, double tight.
And they'll go on the ground. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. And here are the defensive starters. In your old position, you get to talk about the secondary.
The best athletes on the field, Brandon.
Ah, debatable.
Well, we'll see how this goes today. I love the way you put my guys down. But you know this, they've got to cover and they have to tackle. They have a heck of a task in front of them in this game.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. He sets. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Cowboys! Their big-bodied receiver, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys are a little bit jumpy.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, you understand the same. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring up second.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
They'll look to throw. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line.
The tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Out of the gun now on third down. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
You know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Taken right around the 44. The option going right, and he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
But they certainly got dented with that first down run, so now they've got to be back on their heels a little bit as a defense.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because they'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Time running out here on the play clock. Back to throw now on first down. Going for the deep ball. It's caught at the 10. A pickup there of 36. And the Cowboys are set up now with a first and goal. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Give him four on the carry there. It's second and goal. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Third and goal, and he fires one, but incomplete. And forthcoming, a field goal try for the Cowboys. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And his kick here is good. And that will make it 10-0 here in the first. So give them three there. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach, but it kept the offense out of the end zone.
The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held him to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
And this defensive line will be looking to control the point of attack.
And that's what they've done throughout this season. This is a terrific unit. They play together very, very well, and they don't permit big plays to happen.
And his throw is incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Offense trying to avoid stalling out, facing a third and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
'46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. Pulled in at the 24. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bashed it.
Super toe.
That one good for 10 yards, and it'll be second and very short.
That was a good, strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And they'll run it here. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
And that's going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two. They've got it second and 10 to start things out. Here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Let's just go ahead and go back to that play with his eyes because he's got to read his keys. Runner pass right off the top. You're probably going to read an offensive lineman to see if he sets up in pass protection, if he fires out for a running play. The next thing is you're going to check and see what the back's going to do, and if he ends up with the football, okay, now you got to check and see. Does an offensive lineman come downfield and try and block you? Are you going to try to elude him? Are you going to take him on and hold your spot? What are you going to do? In this case, didn't have to do any of that. Saw all of his keys, saw the play in front of him, and ran clean to the ball carrier and finished off the play.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
And a pretty simple completion there underneath, but a successful one for the offense.
Partner, doesn't have to be the big shots downfield all the time. Having that safety net underneath is a great thing for a quarterback.
He lost two there, and it's third down.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Nowhere to go, and nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys. And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz. They dial it up. and it turns into 6 points for him.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice to such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And taken down. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Now that result is no surprise. This team is bringing back memories of what? The 85 Bears, the 2000 Ravens. Those teams were so great against the run, they made you abandon any plans of doing that when you played against them.
Watch it now. Hurry up, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
He'll look to throw. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Look to throw here. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. And out now come the Cowboys. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. No man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Tie right, tie right. Come on, let's go.
They'll look to throw here on first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he is out of bounds. Looks like right at the 15.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
They'll give it to him right up the gut, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A great effort there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And his kick is right through. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That's fielded in the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And a very short pickup there across the 15 to the 16. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And this is incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And this one is incomplete. Ten yards still left on second down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. It'll be a gain of 16 for number 16.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to grade the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. A well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. On play action, they'll throw. Surveying the field. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Looking to throw. Going down the middle, and it's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Offense in a good spot here, second and two.
Here we go! What? Flex round! Flex round!
Back to throw again. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion.
Here we go, D. Here I come. Here we go. What? 90. Flex round.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Fresh set of downs here. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. They'll look to throw now on first down. He's going to loft, and this is caught inside the five. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver in the final seconds of the first half. And the Cowboys continue to pour it on. And they're able to up the lead by one more. Uh-oh, flag comes out here. This is going to be roughing the kicker.
When you're going back there on the kick block, you've got to go to the right point. That didn't happen. Ran into the kicker. The penalty flag had to come out.
Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
The interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw, and that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll throw now on the final play. And this is going to be incomplete. So we have come to halftime here in Dallas with the Cowboys out in front as we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report. So both teams have their marching orders and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
So we've got a second and five. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game, but what a nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one, maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
They'll give it to him right up the gun. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13. They come out here in the eye. They'll look to throw here. He's going to loft one deep. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. A big play here for Dallas. 44 yards. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate.
Here we go.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. Give him 3 on the gain there. Second and goal.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Ball spotted at the 4. It's second and goal. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up 3rd.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be. But we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
Now, Betty is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Their big-bodied receiver, his first touchdown of the year. And the Cowboys add on. Betty puts it through. The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. And on the ground they go with the running back. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
They come up in an offset eye. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
He'll look to throw. And he finds a man on the crossing route. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to 3rd down. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
It takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone. Sometimes you're throwing it between the zones. Sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
Here's Bradley Pinion now as he's on to punt for San Francisco. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Back now here on EA Sports. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. And on second and 10 now, shift together here from the D-line. They come out here in the eye. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he will fight his way forward to about the 23-yard line. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and 7 coming up.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, and you throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set them up.
And the offense needs 7 out of this play on third down. Play clock winding down. Now they'll run it on the toss. And some space here. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. They'll get 6 there on the run, but it brings up fourth down. Here's Pat O'Donnell now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. This is taken at about the 14. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. They come up in an offset eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
Coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
They'll set up to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets him 8.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. 2 yards to go here on third down. Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. Back to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And, yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. 17 yards on the pickup, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. And the defense bit hard there. They were thinking run all the way, play fake, working to perfection on fourth down.
And it was able to work because of the down and distance situation. Fourth and short, you've got to respect the run. You show a little play action. Oftentimes you find people open for what you need, and that's exactly what they got done there. Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, That's a big day.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
But I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw it to the clock. You control the clock because you have
pressure up the middle, and down he goes. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And this is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Cowboys' defense is going to get them the football back. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home, all right? And sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages.
Let's go!
They'll give it to him right up the gut. Taking it right down Broadway. The 20. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly,
skyrocketed.
Right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. And San Francisco gets set to go here. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss. And quickly, they get to the line. They'll look to throw. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. Give him 7 on the play, and they'll be facing a 3rd and 12.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw a completion.
So Charles, are able to complete what so often seems to be elusive, a shutout in the NFL. And maybe what's fitting is they ended the game on the field, that defensive unit on the field. What an exclamation mark.
And probably felt like they could go another 60 minutes without anyone putting points on the board against them. That's the confidence you gain throughout when you're pitching a shutout. And they're going to leave the stadium feeling like they're all 10 feet tall.
So for Dallas, the win moves him up to 5-2 now on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Washington Redskins. Meanwhile, for the 49ers, they dip to 2-5 now with the loss. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Glendale to take on the Cardinals. So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports.